children. One more new geography lesson I'm going to start today. So far we learnt about the North America. Today we are learning South America. That also more interesting than the North America. Okay. So some points about South America already I wrote on the board. That is, it is the fourth largest continent. Seven continents are there. In that, this South America is the fourth largest continent. And Christopher Columbus, he discovered the South America. Hello children, Christopher Columbus, he is also European one. He called the South American natives as a Red Indians. So natives of the South America are called as the Red Indians. Why they are called so? Because it is because of Christopher Columbus. Actually, Christopher Columbus wanted to search the sea route for India. That when he was searching, by mistake he went to the South America and he thought that there are brown colored people were there in the south part of the South America. So he thought that it is only India. Because of this reason, he called them as a Indians. Afterwards, he came to know that it is South America. So that people are called as a Red Indians. I wrote here. Followed? Yes. South America, it is, see children, in the beginning only I wrote, while teaching the geography lesson, while taking any continent, every time I used to say, because of their specialty, they are called by the many other names also. What many names are, other than that, they are called by the many names. That one, the same way, even South America is also called by many names, as land of superlatives, land of Andes, land of grasslands. Like this way, it is called by other names. Yesterday, in the North America children, land of prairies it is called. I taken the grasslands names of the South America. Pampas and all I take, you know, that is in the South America. Why North America is called as a prairies means, that is the basin, great river basin. Missouri and the Mississippi river basin is called as a land of prairies. It is covering the 2/3 area of the North America. Because of that one it is called as a land of prairies. While teaching I told the same thing only. But yesterday while revising I had taken the name of South America. Sorry for that. It is in the South America. Followed. Why it is called grassland means? Because of three big grasslands. Very shortly I explain why these are called by these names. While teaching the points written today, in that time I will go in detail. First one, land of superlatives. Because many physical features are in the superlative degrees. English grammar children, 3 degrees are there. Yes, all are in the superlative degree, not comparative. They are superlative. Like example means biggest, largest, widest, like this. They are in the superlative degrees. Because of that one, it is called land of superlatives. Andes mountain is there, longest mountain range. Amazon river is there, largest river. Then Candor Bird is there, that is the biggest bird. Like this. So all are in the superlative degree. Because of that one, it is called land of superlatives. Yes, land of superlatives, I expect. Land of Andes. Mountain ranges are there children in the South America. They are stretching from north to south part of the continent. Afterwards, I'll show that one in the map. So, they are covering the whole continent. Because of that reason, they are called as the land of Andes. Andes is the mountain name. They are the longest mountain range in the world. Yes, land of grassland. That means three grasslands are there. Pampas, Tampas, Lomas, grasslands are there. Very big one there. Because of that, it is also called as the land of grassland. Follow students. So I teaching will come again. That time I will take in detail. Okay. Just to know the meaning of this one. Next comes location children. Where it comes. See, South America is in the southern hemisphere. northern hemisphere. That one I show in the map. Next, equator and the Tropic of Capricorn. These two latitudes are passing in the South America. Followed, then it is located in the western hemisphere. You know the one? See, in low, middle one is prime and India. So this part is the eastern hemisphere and this one is the western hemisphere. South America will come here in the southern part. Followed, same thing, its location. I will show that one in the map. Take these points and write it. Physical setting. Okay, physical setting of the North, South America. It is surrounded by the water bodies, children. On the three sides, the fourth side, it is having the water bodies. That I will write. Take these points. Yes, physical setting, children. See, almost on all the four sides it is covered by water beach. That is Caribbean Sea. Caribbean Sea in the north, it is there in the map. It will be clear for you. Atlantic Ocean in the east, then Pacific Ocean in the west, and south part it is covered by the ice, children. Icy water it is. Icy water of Antarctica. Antarctica is fully frozen continent, children. Full of ice only it is. There is no people, no vegetation, nothing. So from that ice it is covered in the south part. Okay. Then Panama Canal it separates the south, it means South America from the North America. Very small land it is there between South America and North America. That one, Panama Canal is there in between. Extent, next terms. Size. What is the size of the South America? That is 3.5 times bigger than India. Followed the children. 3.5 India you are joining means you will get the size of the South America. So the area is 178.6 lakh square kilometers. That much area it is having. Okay, then 13 countries are there. In South America, there are 13 countries. Some are big, some are small. Some special countries are there, that one I wrote here. That is, Brazil is the largest country and the Guyana is the smallest country. Followed? Yes. See, children, everything is in the superlative. Largest, smallest. Like that, throughout the continent while learning, we come to know that. Chile is the linear country. It is like a line system country. Then it is not having any broadness. Because Andean mountains are there. I'll show that one in the map. Then Bolivia and Paraguay. These are the countries in the landlocked countries there. Bolivia and Paraguay, landlocked countries. Why they are called so? See, only two are landlocked. Another 11 are. They are having the. Yes, 13 countries are there, children. In that, Brazil is the largest, Guyana is the smallest, and Chile is the linear country because Andean mountain is there. After in between, oceans are there. In between, the Chile mountain country is there. So it is called linear country. Then Bolivia and Paraguay are the landlocked countries. Landlocked. Why means there is no water bodies surrounding them. Other 11 countries are having some one side or another side, they are having the water sources. That many rivers and all is there. But Bolivia and Paraguay are not having any water bodies surrounding them. So they are called as a landlocked countries, children. Followed, no? Landlocked means linear means it is like a line. Then Ecuador, that is the country name. Why it is called Ecuador? That means equator is passing in that country. Because of that one,
that country is called as a Ecuador.
Followed? Yes. What I explained, not children, same thing I am showing in the map. Okay?
Take the physical setting and the extent of the South America.
Yes. World map it is children. Physical map. See, equator is passing here. Below that one only, South America is there. Completely in the southern hemisphere, no? Only small part. See, this is a equator line and only the small portion, not small portion, is in the northern hemisphere. Otherwise, completely it is in the southern hemisphere. It lies in the western hemisphere, children. So, equator is passing here. Then, Andy Mountains. Here it is, children. Andes, they wrote, no? See, up to the south part of the continent, it is Andy Mountain only. Because of that one, it is called as a land of Andes. Then, here, Caribbean Sea in the north. Then, here it is Atlantic Ocean. Then, in the east, it is the Atlantic Ocean, and in the west it is Pacific Ocean. Here it is Pacific Ocean. It is in the west of the South America. East is Atlantic Ocean and Caribbean Sea is in the north. And down here, children, after this one, it is ice water is there, that Antarctica's, that one is there. Okay? Yes. Yes, see children, 13 countries I told, no, in the South America, all that one they given in your class textbook, children. Every country is having the different color. Chile, I said, no, children, it is purple. See, it is just like a line, it is. So it is a linear country. And where the equator is passing, here equator is passing, here the Ecuador is the country. And Brazil is the largest, I told. Here it is pink color one, all it is the Brazil. Guyana, that is here. See, green color, very small country it is. Guyana. Okay? Yes. This is the South America, children. In your textbook it is there.
Yes. For today, children, introduction, location, physical setting, and extent I take enough for today. In the next class, I will take the physical divisions or physical features of the South America. You take homework for today's session, children. South America is which largest continent? It's right, you have to write. Who discovered the South America? Who discovered it? This name you have to write. Then, why natives of South America called as Red Indians? Yes, where is South America located? It is in the southern hemisphere, but it is towards the west part. So, I have to write, it is in the western hemisphere. Okay, yes. Name countries which are landlocked in South America. How many countries are there in South America? Next, which is the linear country in the South America? Okay, children, very simple like that. Do this homework and next time I will tell you the features of the South America. Okay, children? Yes, thank you.